Continuity is a series of features that shows off the power of Apple's tight hardware and software ecosystem. You can do things that you would never expect are possible on a PC or Android device. Unfortunately, that also means no one knows what they are or how to look for them. So today I'm going to walk you through all of the continuity features you can take advantage of if you have several Apple devices in your life. Number one, continuity camera. If you want to up the video quality when you're having video calls over FaceTime, Zoom, WebEx, Microsoft Teams, look no further than the camera you already have in your pocket on your iPhone. All you have to do is lock your iPhone, keep it horizontal and steady behind your display using a mount or even a tripod or a pile of books. And then suddenly, instead of using the grainy little webcam built into your MacBook, you'll use the high-quality sensor on your iPhone. That's pretty much all you have to do, and your video will instantly look crisper, clearer, and sharper. Number two, Handoff. This lets you seamlessly continue your work across devices. So you start doing something on your Mac, you open your iPhone, you go to the multitasking screen, and you can tap on the little bubble, and whatever you are writing in an email, you can keep writing on your phone. This goes the other way too. If you're reading an article on your phone, you sit down at your Mac, you'll see an extra Safari icon on the right side of the dock. You click it, and it'll instantly bring up the same window. This is something other apps on the App Store can take advantage of as well. Number three, universal control. So anytime I have two Macs, or a Mac and an iPad sitting next to each other on my desk, I always want to use the keyboard and trackpad directly in front of me, so I'll be wiggling on the mouse, being like, why isn't this working? And I realize I'm looking at the wrong screen entirely. Well, with universal control, that's actually possible. All you have to do is move the mouse to the edge of the screen and just sort of keep pushing, and it'll break free to the other device. And once that starts, both the mouse and the keyboard from one Mac control both Macs. It doesn't just stop there. You can have any permutation of Macs and iPads, up to three of them, controlled from one keyboard and mouse. You can even drag files between the two computers to move them around. Now, you can't just go around controlling strangers' computers and iPads in coffee shops. They both need to be signed into the same Apple ID. An unfortunate side effect of that, of course, is that if you have a personal computer and a work computer, they're probably not signed into the same Apple ID, so this might not work in that situation. Honestly, if you are signed into your personal Apple ID on a work computer, what the fuck are you doing? Get that off of there. You don't want your employer seeing your texts and your pic. Number four, this one is small but mighty. Continuity clipboard. So you have a thing on your phone, you want the thing on your Mac, you don't want to email yourself, you don't want to text yourself, you don't want to AirDrop, just copy it on your iPhone and paste it on your Mac. It's that simple. You don't have to retype passwords, you don't have to send yourself pictures, you can just copy it on your iPhone, paste it on your Mac. Number five saves even an additional step from that, import from iPhone. So say you're filling out an online web form for insurance, banking, travel site, healthcare, you know, one of the four horsemen of bad web design. And in order to keep your sanity, you're doing it on a real computer with a keyboard and mouse. So you get to one step, and then suddenly it's asking you to take a picture of your ID or a document or something. And you're like, oh no, should I have been doing this on my phone all along? I don't have a camera on my computer. Well, here's a solution. You open the preview app on your Mac, you go to File, Import from iPhone, Take Photo. You pick up your phone and you instantly see that the camera app is opened. You just snap it and there it is on your Mac. And then since it's in the preview app, you can instantly resize it or export it to whatever requirements you need. Number six, unlock your Mac with your Apple Watch. So Touch ID is one of the best features to trickle back from the iPhone over to the Mac. You don't have to type your password in every time. You just push your finger on the special key and you're instantly in. But a lot of times you might want your laptop closed, docked to a monitor. Or you might want to use a different keyboard that doesn't have the Touch ID key on it. Well, you open System Settings, Login and Password, and if you have an Apple Watch on your Apple ID, you just check it, and that watch will unlock your Mac. All you have to do is wake up your Mac, you'll feel a little click on your wrist, and your watch has logged you in. And I have to say, it encouraged me to use a longer, more secure password on my computer. It doesn't matter to me because I don't actually have to type it. So those are all my favorite continuity features. There are even more out there. On a Mac, you can answer phone calls and text messages from your iPhone. You can authenticate Apple Pay transactions using your Apple Watch. If you lose your Wi-Fi signal, you can use your iPhone as a personal hotspot. Links to all of those, along with an article version of this video, are in the video description. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.